Welcome to Drawfee, where we take your dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Julia.
I'm Karina.
I'm Nathan.
And I'm Jacob.
All right, y'all, this is long overdue, but I'm getting revenge here tonight.
Oh.
Karina's all about it.
Grudge
get
match.
Get their asses.
It's a grudge match.
Whoever it is you're getting vengeance on, they're going to get it.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm getting vengeance on? I'm getting vengeance on you, Karina.
Oh no.
Many moons ago, we did an impossible coloring challenge where you and you, Jacob.
Yeah.
I pointed to you.
Yeah, you did.
Yes.
Yeah.
Can confirm.
Challenged me to color a drawing that you two drew.
Yeah.
And it was a mess.
I liked it.
Yeah, it made our beautiful queen, Bella LaBall.
Bella LaBall. Yeah.
Yes, Bella LaBall with her brain out, disco ball, rock shoulder.
Fish shoes.
Fur, but also chainmail shirt. So we're doing this to you now. But also I brought Nathan in as well. Because I just like to have a supportive Nathan, but also
like
Nathan's going to be challenging you.
We all like having a Nathan around.
And I get to help. I'm getting revenge for not being in that episode.
Yes. I've enlisted some help to really challenge you. So anything that we draw today, you got to color.
Fine. I accept your challenge.
Hell yes.
I'm glad
hell
you did.
Yeah.
Because the episode would end.
I say, no, I don't really want to do that, you guys. And then
I go,
to
oh,
stop.
Okay. Okay, yeah. That's fair. I'm sorry.
We did not discuss beforehand.
Straight into the recycling bin with this one, fellas.
Start recording and then decide what the episode topic is going to be.
So, Nathan, do you want to start off the drawing?
No. Just kidding, yes.
Oh,
wow.
Dang it.
The level of two today is through the roof.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
We're full of vengeance today.
Was this a WWE grudge match?
Kind of.
Nah, wrestling is fake. This beef is real.
It's real. We're mad at each other.
Whoa.
This ain't your impossible beef. This is real beef.
Nice.
But it's kind of impossible because it's an impossible coloring challenge.
Oh damn. The beef grows.
Wow.
It's big beef.
I'm just starting with fire.
Yeah, this is a Promare fire.
Because yeah. I don't know how to color this, but I know Karina does.
Well, so far it's very possible, this coloring challenge.
Yeah, I thought I was supposed to be getting a hard one with this one. God, can you maybe like step it up a little, dude?
Okay.
I'm bored.
Yawn.
Let me take a sip of my coffee.
That was an intense sip.
I was shaking the cup the whole time I was drinking, clearly.
Clearly, this is one of what will be many light sources in this.
Very well.
Oh.
Maybe it's being conjured somehow, this fire.
By a hand, perhaps?
By a hand.
That's a good spot to conjure fire from.
Yeah.
I don't know. You could do it from, like, other surfaces.
Idea. I have an idea.
Yes.
Okay.
Because it's an impossible coloring challenge, which means that Karina will have to render this, it's actually being summoned at the bottom of a foot that's upturned.
Yeah, erase that hand, please.
That's more like an impossible drawing challenge, which is an idea I have for a future episode,
this is,
so please
a challenge
don't waste it.
For me to draw a foot.
Damn
upturned,
it.
But we're gonna get there.
It's been but gross. A few minutes, and we're already on the foot
this,
shit.
This sucks.
Because of Julia.
Yeah.
Julia's getting her revenge.
They do this in Avatar. They, like, do fire out of their feet and fly around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, well, like,
and they kick it out their feet, too.
Yeah.
This is an Avatar fan art challenge.
Just this drawing.
All right. And then the one other thing I wanted to get, I don't want to take up too much room or time, but I figure since it's me, my contribution, and y'all can figure out how these elements fit together, but I do want there to be a horse.
Horms.
Do you think that horses are, like, difficult to color?
Well, because they've got hair, but they're also kind of shiny.
That's true, actually.
Because I never really render the horses. I'm good at, like, the line art for horses, but again, I kind of want to see...
I'm not going to make the same mistake Julia made and egg you on too much by giving you ideas of how to make this harder, but, you know, take that as your hint. Sip.
Nathan. What could the horse be made out of to make it more difficult to render? Macaroni and cheese.
Macaroni and cheese mane.
Whoa. It's massive. That noodle.
That's a big noodle.
It's a big, it doesn't have to be that big. You want to be little? Little Mac?
Little Mac?
Well, each Mac you draw is one Mac Karina must color.
I see.
Plus, it's also one that you have to draw, so
you know I can really rough them in, and then you've got to figure it out.
Yeah, you got to figure out what it looks like when cheese sauce is on a horse, and how that sort of interplays with the horse's hair.
How hard can that be to find reference for?
Yeah,
you know, now that I'm thinking about it, shooting fire at your foot is quite a feat.
I'm getting pissed off.
Okay, Nathan, you can stop.
Oh.
I said stop.
He's laughing naturally. He can't stop.
Ooh. Wow.
I love this composition. It makes it seem like the macaroni and cheese horse is, like, bewitched by this firefoot.
I mean, we all are.
The mac and cheese horse is the audience surrogate.
This really has the vibes of a stock photo challenge, but there's no stock photo.
I'm just doing.
Yeah. When Julia did this, she got one, like, beautiful character.
I did.
Didn't y'all also give her mac and cheese to draw?
Yeah.
Okay.
At some point?
Yeah, there was some mac and... I think the chainmail turned into mac and cheese at some point.
But it wasn't... Yeah. It wasn't on a horse, so that's different.
Yeah, it's different. The interplay is different. Important textural considerations to be made here.
And you know what? Maybe... It's like a Pikachu horse, so we've
what
got
the
some
fuck?
We've got some lightning. We've got some lightning coming out as well.
Damn. This image makes no sense.
I really thought we were going that Nathan was going to draw a portion of a character and then I was going to continue.
Yeah, portions of multiple characters.
I have so much to think about now. I thought it was going to be like a soft toss of the ball to me, but
it
now
it's...
It
could be one character.
Y'all were egging me on to make it more complicated, so here we go.
Everyone's like out to get each other on this episode. This is the one where we tear ourselves apart.
Yeah, macaroni horse ruins it for everyone.
Macaroni horse chew.
Nobody expects macaroni horse. Yeah, I'm just going to leave it there.
Okay.
And y'all figure it out.
You're not even going to draw the hardest part of the horse.
What's the hardest part of the horse?
We'll figure it out.
I'll draw one leg.
Okay, perfect.
I'll draw one horse leg. This one.
Because you're about to hand me the reins to a horse, and you know how that turns out.
I mean, it's the most appropriate thing to hand the reins of.
He got you there, buddy.
Got a little knobbly knee there.
Yep.
This is a compositional nightmare.
No.
This is like evoking that scene of Indiana Jones where he replaces the treasure with like the bag, the weighted bag.
Uh-huh.
It looks like he's reaching up to the fire.
But the treasure is fire. And the pedestal is foot and Indiana Jones is horns.
And mane is macaroni.
This image is making me stupid.
Yeah,
welcome to Drawfee.
This is a wonderful horse, by the way, Nathan. I feel like we're always being really aggro, and I need to rein it back in by saying your horses are great as usual.
Don't do that.
Do what? Don't, drink my coffee?
You're stooping to Julia's level.
Hit the microphone, sorry.
This is chaos.
We had just recently had a meeting where we had talked about how we were going to try to avoid thumps
and bad audio sounds.
And now Karina's shaking an iced coffee at the mic and slapping it into the microphone.
This is going to be our thumpiest episode yet.
I'll have you know that I have not thumped once otherwise, to my knowledge. Shut up.
These are intentional comedic thumps.
Yeah.
That can be comedy, left in. For ha-has.
Yeah.
And tee-hees.
The people watching will tee-hee.
Okay. Okay.
Are you done, Nathan?
I guess.
Okay.
I get, you know, feel free to erase stuff that doesn't work.
I will
erase
not.
The whole drawing.
Yeah, erase it and start over. This was a warm up.
Okay, it's my turn to add to this.
Add, jeez. Subtract, change
to this.
You know, we started off pretty wild. And I think that's correct.
Yeah.
Pretty wild is one way of saying it, yeah.
Wild horses.
So I've got like two things I thought of immediately.
Okay.
So?
The first one is that the horse's body sort of becomes...
Oh, it's long.
a hot dog.
Yeah, a hot dog.
No, ew. No.
Oh.
like a wet.
Does it look like that?
A wet, glistening hot dog.
Ew.
I was about to say, well, that makes more sense with the mac and cheese, but it doesn't.
I had a hot dog with mac and cheese. I just don't like that it's, you know, like phallic. Kind of phallic.
No, it's not. It's a hot dog horse.
You ever?
Hot dogs are phallic.
What if I give it another leg?
You ever go to put mac and cheese on your hot dog and then realize it was a horse actually? That ever
still
happen?
Still no.
None of this is
relatable.
I know that feeling, Nathan. That's happened to me.
Like, we get it, Jacob. You didn't want to draw a horse body.
It's you don't want to render a wet hot dog, and that's your demon to deal with.
You got me there.
I love all the different elemental typings we have represented. We've got fire, lightning, wet
cheese. Meat. The four elements.
They're all here.
Everyone is here.
Oh, what's this?
I wanted to put in a hand.
Okay.
Sort of a big hand.
Can you stop drawing phalluses?
This isn't a phallus, it's a hand. Shut up, Photoshop.
Photoshop agrees. It looks like you're trying to draw something nasty. Are you sure?
It's sort of like a master hand situation.
Oh, okay. That hand's way bigger than the foot.
Yeah, so this hand is like coming in.
What'd that hand do?
Oh, this is a good hand, Jacob.
Thank you. I did do some hand practice today, so I got like hands on the mind.
Wow, you drew stuff before we started recording?
Yeah, dude, I did. Not to brag.
Try hard over here.
But I did. So this hand is made of glass.
Okay.
It's a glass hand, so it's going to sort of reflect everything in the environment.
Can you leave me a note?
Yeah.
Thanks.
This is glass, and maybe it's even got like sort of the master hand.
Oh, it's got a little glove.
Sort of glove. Well, glass is like really hard because you can see through it, but also it's reflective.
Yeah, but only a little.
But it does reflect.
Yeah, I guess you can decide how
see-through
it is.
Okay, so we got big glass
looks
hand.
Looks like he's coming to give the horse a little pet.
Or like a little
squeeze
tickle.
That meat.
Oh, it would be so squishy. So auditorily bad.
And we've got sort of an optical illusion happening with the lightning sort of becoming the back of the hot dog, which I really like.
Oh.
Yeah. We're going to, let's play into that a little bit. We'll sort of make it.
Make it make sense.
Like that.
Figure it out.
And then I think the only other thing I'll add, so we have plenty of room.
Yeah.
Let's move this note. This the horse is not horse, glass.
The macaroni is glass. Oh, no. Okay.
Is that the moon is back here. So it's casting a moonlight. It's casting a moonlight.
It's casting a moonlight.
From behind on everything.
Just like Sailor Moon.
Just like Sailor Moon. All right. I feel like I need to leave space for Julia. Yeah. So do you want to go ahead and swap
you can,
in?
Again, okay. you can shrink it.
No, we can't.
Make this whole thing like a painting in the background of the actual scene.
Julia got a character.
I thought you were going to get a character too, but we have to follow in Nathan's footsteps.
The horse is a character.
The horse was a character, and then you made into a hot dog wiener.
That makes it more interesting.
It's food horse, Kachu.
Yeah.
Horse.
Food horse, Kachu.
It's food horse, Kachu, Karina. Get used to it, or get out.
I got a character, but the character's materials changed about every inch of that character.
And that's what I was expecting. What the hell is this?
So, are those waves?
Yeah. So this is all happening in the middle of the ocean.
Okay.
This really does evoke one of those like weird fantasy Photoshops that you'd find on like a poster in a Spencer's Gifts.
It's just a weird photo match.
Yeah, where it's always like a stormy ocean and like a door and a dragon.
Yeah, and a hand.
And a hot dog horse, Kachu.
And a foot.
It's just this. All right, what's all that back there?
So these are just clouds because it's a stormy.
Okay, stormy seas.
Stormy day.
So clouds.
A stormy day where you can see the moon.
Yeah, stormy day, moon perfectly visible.
Well, the clouds are moving in.
Yeah.
It's one of those half stormy day nights.
Yeah. Oh, we got some shooting stars?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're leaving. Those stars are shooting away from this place.
Yeah, what is happening? They were coming towards this planet, and then they were like, yeah, I don't know about this weird, and they turned around.
Well, this is the anti-star ritual that the foot flame
what
is doing
to, yeah, get, that makes
to make
sense.
The stars leave.
Nathan's right.
You know
the anti-star ritual?
Of the foot flame?
To make the stars leave.
I mean, Julia, feel free to add materials to the stuff that
we've
drawn.
I do gotta be honest. This isn't that impossible.
No, it's very probable.
Make it more. It's probable. It's possible.
We
always wearing
this image probable.
A nice collar shirt.
This feels more like an impossible drawing challenge again.
It's not. We all drew it successfully.
It's a difficult hand.
Easy.
Horses are notoriously hard. You have an upside down foot.
Yeah, but it was easy to draw. So very possible on that. Maybe we're just too good at art.
Yeah.
Maybe nothing's impossible when you're a skilled artiste.
Apparently not. Bet y'all weren't expecting this one today. But here it is.
I think you're going to be doing this later, Karina, and you're going to get to glass hand, and it's gonna cause you more issues than you expect.
I don't know. I'm kind of excited about glass hand. Like, that's kind of a fun material.
What's this? Is this a mesh bow tie?
No, it's one of those bow ties that, like, is covered in lights. Have you ever seen those?
Oh, like a light, like an LED?
Yeah.
Bow tie?
Yeah.
Okay.
LED bow tie.
Yeah.
All lights, or is it just the ones that are dark?
It's the bow tie is all lights.
Okay, the whole thing is lights.
Yeah.
I'm going to open this later and be like, can you please give me a rundown of what the fuck I'm looking at again?
And then we're going to send you messages that are like, the bow tie is lights, the hand is glass, and it's going to sound like a riddle.
I think you're going to open this later and immediately die. Like, I think this is one where if you look at it twice, it kills you.
I can never look away. I'm on my one look.
Yeah, this is the one look, so enjoy it. This is like the new sequel to The Ring, but it's this image.
The drawing.
Yeah, and it goes viral on the internet.
Yeah, can this be the next, like, smile dog creepypasta? Just like, if you look at this image, you like become stuck in it. What's that? Was that Donald Duck?
I changed my mind.
Okay.
Aw.
Okay, we've got sort of a...
It's Goofy. Oh, no. It's my BFF drowning Goofy.
For a second, it kind of looked like Goofy.
It's crystalline Goofy. Are they crystals or are they swords?
Crystals.
Okay.
Ocean crystals.
Whoa.
Well, he has to obviously siphon power from the ocean crystals for the ritual.
For the anti-star flame foot ritual.
This feels like a dark Lisa Frank. right?
Yeah, it does.
There's a horse on the water and there's a lot of bright...
Horse on the water. A glass hand in the sky.
God. How is any of this stuff even in the ocean?
Magic.
Yeah, the crystals are right there.
Yeah.
Oh.
They go down really deep. We're only seeing the very tip of the crystal structure.
The crystal berg.
Just the tip.
Oh, what's this?
Is that a mouse?
Is wearing a wig?
Yeah.
Oh. The crystal's wearing a wig?
Yeah.
I hope I forget that it's a wig and I make it into a mouse in the render.
I'm just trying to think of what's hard to color. Hair? Realistic human hair?
I feel like we really laid it on for Julia's and y'all are softballing me. I'm honestly kind of disappointed.
We're trying.
I was left with such little room.
I told you to make it smaller.
No! I refuse to step on your art.
Add some more stuff to the horse. Karina, what's hard for you to render, Karina?
I'm not telling you.
Make each toenail a different material.
I feel like something that's little, that's difficult to render, and you have to render each individual one.
Scales. Fish scales.
Fish scales.
On the leg.
Horse leg, fish scales.
It's an ocean leg. Ocean foot.
What if his head is made of scales?
The horse?
Yeah.
The horse?
A seahorse.
Oh, yeah.
Macaroni seahorse dog kachoo.
Macaroni seahorse dog kachoo.
I'm betting on that horse during the Kentucky Derby.
Not even the longest name.
No. Up next, macaroni seahorse kachoo.
You missed dog.
Oh my God.
This is why you're not allowed to announce the Kentucky Derby.
It's true.
Kentucky Derby.
That's when they race ducks.
Oh, that's pretty. Now it's a dragon.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
Wow.
I still hate it, but like...
But this part is...
Horse, still.
Is fur. Or horse, as Nathan said.
Yeah.
What kind of fur does your dog have? Horse?
Horse fur. What if there's like some leather somewhere? Is leather hard to render?
I'm not telling you.
Well, you're over there talking shit.
Yeah, it's what I do.
What if the hot dog is like twisting around?
Ooh.
Do you mind, Jacob?
Ew.
He does mind. He does, in fact, mind.
It's like a spiraled hot dog. Ew, I don't like it.
It's twisting.
Oh, it's like one of those lollipops.
It's like one of those lollipops.
It's like one of those lollipops, but hot dog.
But hot dog.
Does twisting make it harder to render?
Yeah.
Well, because then you got to get the material of the hot dog twisting in space.
Well, it's just meat.
Yeah, but it has the casing.
That just makes it smooth.
Well, then you got to make it like shiny and it crumples while you're twisting it.
I mean, I guess.
It gets those wrinkles.
And hot dogs. Kind of doing the work for me.
They got like little like pores on them.
Yeah. And again, the meat's, it's very wet still.
Yeah, it's wet. It's wet meat. It's twisted up wet meat.
In the moonlight. But there's
in the
also
moonlight, yeah.
But there's also electricity and reflected light from the ocean and the lights from the LED bow tie.
I just feel like I'm better at coming up with evil ideas than you guys.
The hot dog is electrified from within.
It's electrifying.
From within.
From within.
Oh, yeah. Maybe. Okay. Here's an idea.
Uh-huh.
There's like, it's a little bit translucent and you can see some of the skeleton through the hot dog.
And it's electrified.
And it's electrified. Yeah.
Damn. Y'all are making Julia do the heavy lifting.
I'm just throwing stuff out. She doesn't have to do
we were
anything.
Doing a good job. And then Karina's like, actually, this sucks. And now we feel like we have to go further.
Actually, this is baby easy drawing.
I'm just saying, Julia got like Nightcore Seinfeld or whatever, Frasier.
Frasier. Oh, we do need we do need a little screen with.
Should Seinfeld be in here?
Yeah. Nightcore Seinfeld.
Oh, inside?
Yeah. Oh, inside felt.
Oh, you'll have to like see the screen through inside felt. Julia, please draw in Seinfeld.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Oh God, what does Jerry Seinfeld look like?
Like that. Head. You're doing great.
His characteristic look is that little like mullety, curly mullety hair he's got.
He looks like the sound "hey," right?
He kind of looks like ah.
Yeah.
Well,
hey.
George.
Like, right.
Yeah, that's kind of him.
Elaine.
Elaine.
Newman.
Newman.
Did y'all see that? I think it was a TikTok where it was that Mr. Brightside, the Killers song, but they had a picture of Jerry Seinfeld up while they play it, and it turns out that he sounds exactly like Jerry Seinfeld when he sings that song.
I'll send it to y'all because I was the one who showed Jacob.
When you look at Jerry Seinfeld and hear Mr. Brightside, it sounds exactly like Jerry Seinfeld is singing the song and it ruins it for you forever.
I'll take your word for it because I don't look at TikTok. Anyway, follow Drawfee on TikTok.
Jacob, I think you mean it makes it better.
It's really funny.
I've always wished that Jerry Seinfeld sang more The Killers songs.
Well, your wish is about to be granted, my friend.
Buddy.
Nathan!
Jacob!
Is that?
Nah, I guess.
Yeah, I feel like we failed at doing a real challenge.
This is
here.
Challenging.
It'll be difficult, but I just...
I got macaroni chainmail.
Yeah.
And human hair.
Give it some... I mean, there's human hair. There's macaroni.
Yeah. There's a twisted, translucent, electrified hot dog with Jerry Seinfeld inside of it.
Inside Feld.
Damn.
And you're telling me this is easy.
You're telling me.
Are you telling me?
Are telling me.
If you want something done right, maybe I gotta do it myself. I'll make it harder for myself.
Yeah, add some more stuff.
Yeah, apparently. I do find this image very upsetting. And I'm not looking forward to rendering it. The challenge is that I have to look at it.
Yeah,
maybe that's what's impossible.
Longer than the rest of you. Jeez.
You're going to make this look good somehow, like a cohesive composition.
I don't know about cohesive, but I think I got this.
Well, I'm excited to see the speed draw right now.
Whoa!
All right, we're back. The coloring has been done.
Where am I?
How did it go, Karina?
It went well.
Impossible at all.
I felt like I came off very cocky while y'all were drawing. So I didn't want to fumble the coloring and
Frankly, I think that cockiness was a little earned.
Damn, all right.
Amazing.
Well, shall we start watching what you did?
I do want to preface this with my usual hi. Sorry about any flashing imagery. I realized this after I had finished the recording because I really turned my brain off and did this in one sitting, which I don't usually do. But I sure do love to flip the canvas. Huh. And for no reason most of the time. So there are a lot of instances, especially later in the process, where I'm just flipping the canvas really quickly for no reason. And it does kind of flash in the speed draw. So just keep that in mind while you're watching if you're sensitive to like little flickers of imagery, because it annoyed me a little and I'm sorry. I didn't realize how much I was doing it.
You've had your warning.
Yeah, because I was really focused on the absurdity of this image, and mm-hmm. I did not think about how often I was hitting my flip canvas button.
We're going to take the button away from you.
You can. I love it too much.
It turns out this episode was a challenge for everyone involved.
Yeah. Including you.
Including you, watching. The viewer.
Keep Sorry. Watching this challenge. Impossible. All right, let's play it.
Let's get into it.
3, 2, 1, go.
So I did set a few arbitrary rules for myself with this. Ooh. Namely, that I wouldn't use like any brushes that will, you know, generate things for me. So, you know, draw all the scales individually. Nothing that'll make clouds or anything. Just normal brushes and treat it similarly to how Julia did with her impossible coloring challenge of just do it all meself.
Yeah. Brute force it.
Yeah.
No macaroni brush.
No macaroni brush. We draw the noodles like champs.
In this house.
Well, I realized after the fact that depending on what kind of macaroni recipe you used, like if it's a real creamy one, you wouldn't really see the noodles. So.
That's true. Oh. Just love.
Fix it later. But yeah, so I decided to just kind of take a more... I guess painterly approach to this. I lined it using like a little pencil. So it's more, I don't know, loose and stuff. I think that was supposed to be an LED. You'll have just watched the drawing process. And for me, it's been like a week. So I'm like, I think that was supposed to be LED. That's what I was leaving notes for myself of
yeah,
like,
LED.
Yeah,
what I think everything was supposed to be before I completely forgot. But yeah.
This line works real nice.
Thank you. I followed the line art pretty precisely because I was like... And yeah, you gotta.
But you added a little pizzazz to it, too.
Oh, shucks.
A little detail, a little good looking.
Oh, shucks.
Nice foot.
Thanks. So I kind of did this in three parts. These three things, well, four with... The crystal, the hand, the foot, the horse. That's all the hand, one the foot, section.
The, horse. The crystal, the hand, the foot, the horse. Horse. The crystal, the hand, the foot, the horse.
So that is the quote-unquote foreground. And then the background is its own thing. And then there's like a lighting layer. So I lined the foreground and had it like filled and stuff. And... Yeah, I don't like how this came out either, police.
That was an ambulance for us.
Yeah, for me. Yeah. So then I just kind of flatted everything in so I kind of knew what I was working with here.
The color change is really vile.
And so these are our characters, and then I went into the background so I could start placing that. I put a little fog on the water because I thought that would look nice.
Yep, correct.
In reality, I'm not sure why that was the first thing I did because it was indicated nowhere, but I liked it.
Yeah.
So then there's the moon, and got to do some water lighting.
Oh, God.
And then... Put some water texturing and stuff.
Yeah.
Painted all that in. Very
yeah.
Got very painty with the background. So as you can see, the moon is casting the main light on the water. yada, yada.
What is the main light here? Because there's also lightning.
Yeah, we'll get there. Fire. We'll get there. And then here's like the mountains. There were like mountains. So those I just kind of like Bob Rossed in. Also, this is where I start flipping the canvas.
Horses
for
dancing.
No reason. I don't know why I was flipping it so much. I didn't realize how much I was doing it. I don't know. I'm so sorry. And then this was supposed to be glass. So I was kind of messing around with how I didn't use any reference. So I was kind of just trying to guess what glass looks like. And I wanted it, you know, to still be kind of see-through, but also like I don't know. So it has kind of frosty and it was kind of indicating where highlights may be and stuff. And she just keeps flipping the canvas. but after a while, I kind of like give up on it because it was like annoying me.
And I remember when I was saying glass hand was going to give you some trouble, you're like, eat shit, Jacob. I draw glass hand every day.
I mean, I get it later, but it was getting to the point where I was like, I need to stop focusing on the hand and like get to other parts of this. So I kind of like get it to a point and then I'm just like, okay.
it's just so much flipping.
I don't know what I was flipping for.
There's no reason to do it.
I just like flipping. Okay.
You're just doing it for fun.
Yeah. So I throw in the fire here.
Throw in the fire.
Yeah. Make it real bright and stuff. Make it real zany looking.
I'm so glad I included this. I just like watching you do it. I know it's not hard for you to do, but it is fun for me to watch.
Yeah, it was also good to have because that side of the canvas was just very dark, so it was just a good thing to have there. And
well,
this
that's
is where
why the foot casted the fire to make some light.
So then I make that see-through. I don't remember if it was supposed to be see-through, but I made it see-through.
Yeah, it was.
Okay.
How else would you see Jerry Seinfeld?
But I don't know how see-through it was supposed to be in comparison.
We never specified, I don't think.
No.
So now I start doing like the nitty-gritty of the shading. And yeah, I'm still flipping. And I couldn't tell you why.
You know, I wouldn't have noticed it, I don't think, if you hadn't pointed it out.
How can you not notice it? I'm just like, I feel like this is more than usual. Why was I doing it so much? What the hell?
You needed something to break up just doing it in one sit.
We wanted to create the impression that a horse was telling you no.
No.
So again, I am sorry to our viewing audience. I didn't realize how much I was hitting the six key. But yeah, so main light source, the fire. The mac and cheese, I made it gooey, so it's got them gooiness.
I do want to eat it.
Yeah,
it's good.
Yeah,
gooey mac.
It's not one of them crunchy ones.
Mm-mm.
And
no dry mac.
I think
here.
The horse was supposed to be wet, so I was trying to give it a bit of a wet look, which I will do more later. There's a little bit of lighting coming from the moon on the sausage.
When the moon hits sausage.
really, really cast the back of the foot into shadow because the fire coming out of the foot would be so bright that I was like, oh yeah, I need to color in. What was this? Night Course Seinfeld? That's what it was to me.
It was.
Yeah. So that just is.
Why is Jerry so sad?
I don't know.
Because he's making that noise.
But since that's an LED screen, it also has light. And I wanted to do a little bit of iridescent on the scaling. So then I just make it like colorful with the highest points of contrast being coming from the fire. Put some orange on the mackie cheese to make it real mackie. So I was like adding in just like little touches. I think this is where I make the horse wet.
that Karina, time the in every going drawing. Great,
but can you make the horse wet, please?
The horse is wet now.
Okay, thank you.
And this is where I go back to the hand now that I'm more prepared and
now that
so, so attached to flipping the canvas. So I add some reflection of the water as well as the moon and a little bit of the horse, a hint of horse reflection on that finger coming towards us. But yeah.
I mean, that's just a good art tip is like if you're having trouble drawing a glass hand, draw Seinfeld and make the horse wet first and then come back.
Yeah, and then go back.
Yeah. You gotta work the whole thing. You can't get too stuck on the glass hand.
Yeah.
So this is where I add some water shading to give texture to the water because I think it's supposed to have a little wave and stuff. And
beautiful waves.
Thank you. And
little foam.
Stars. And then I was like, oh right, the lightning. God forbid I forget the lightning.
It is a Pikachu horse.
Yeah, so then you just do some glowy bits, and since that's a strong light, that's gonna cast even more light on various things. So then I add even more highlights.
Can we name this episode Three Idiots Force a Professional Artist to Render Some Bullshit?
I forgot to wish one of my friends happy birthday because I was working on this. But so then I add some reflections in the water to come from the LED screen as well as the fire. And yeah.
Wow.
Oh my God.
You made it. You made it art.
I want this spray painted on someone's van.
It's not mine. Gotta be.
But someone's.
Yeah. Let us know if you decide to. Yes.
I want you, the viewer, next time your friend is having a birthday, get this printed on a cake.
Yeah.
And give it to them with no explanation.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is Dark Lisa Frank.
Yeah. Next time you're having, like, you know how at weddings they play, like, a slideshow that have all the beautiful moments of a couple together?
Slip this one in.
Yeah, but make sure you flip it randomly every few seconds.
Yeah.
For just a moment.
It just goes back and forth. I just keep looking at the hair on the crystals. It's so stupid. What a stupid thing I drew.
I don't know why that was there.
The crystal was, you know, self-conscious about not having any hair. So it got a little wig.
Someone's wig flew off and got caught on the crystals.
I had a weird amount of fun doing this.
Well, you did great.
It's so good.
But it wasn't impossible. We didn't make it hard enough for you.
Well, next time we do this, someone else will be coloring, and I'll be back in the deciding what's hard to do chair, and you didn't hit any of the ideas that I thought would be hard, so
I'm so excited to find out what those were.
Me and Nathan both are going to be so much worse at this than either you or Julia.
I'm never doing the coloring part of this challenge.
It's all on you, Jacob.
Shit. I refuse.
All right, it'll be me next then. I'll give it my best shot.
We're having the one artist on this team who's colorblind before the one who's not colorblind.
Coloring
challenge.
I can do it. I have to face my fears.
You got this.
Of not being able to perceive colors properly. Damn, Karina. This is a masterpiece.
Yeah.
Well, we've all made it together.
Can we sell this on a notebook like a Lisa Frank?
Can we put it on a binder? Like a trapper keeper?
Yeah.
100%. Or mouse pad. I want this as one of those wide mouse pads.
Yeah, the like whole desk ones for gamers.
Okay, for real though. DFTBA, let's go.
Yeah, let us know if you'd be interested in buying that, and we will take that feedback 100% seriously. So don't lie to us.
Well, thanks for watching this, everyone. Yeah. I hope this hasn't done anything harmful to your psyche to view this. But if you're still feeling sound of mind, click the like button, subscribe to the channel if you enjoyed it.
Yeah, and if you want to support us on Patreon so that we can force Jacob to do this, let's you can go check that out. And also, if you see this horse in the ocean at night, watch us on Twitch. Monday nights.
It's your calling. And be sure to keep your eye on the store. Because this is going to show up there somehow, some way. Just you wait and see.
It will.
We're sorry.
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 Well, I'm not that sorry.